Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst of Chatterbox Quilts. I want to show you one of my favorite features on the Janome Horizon Memory Craft 9400 QCP, and that is the HP needle plate and the foot that goes with it. So as a quilter, I am striving to get that perfect quarter inch seam, and the HP needle plate and industrial grade foot give me that. So let's take a look at them. Here is the needle plate. You can see that it's the HP one because it tells you right on it, and it is a straight stitch plate. So there is no zigzag happening with this needle plate at all. Here is the foot, and the indicator for it says HP on the back here in very small letters. But how you can tell that this is the HP foot is the fact that the foot is integral with the foot holder. So unlike some of the other presser feet on this machine, this is all in one piece. So you can see what it looks like there. Now to put it on the machine, let me just show you that. Let's put our needle plate in first. So I make sure that my foot is up, so it gives me that room to slide in the needle plate. There are a couple little tabs there. You want to just slide them right in, and then you want to press down this circle to snap it right into the machine. Then to put the foot on, I want to make sure my screw is loose enough. You may even have to take it right off. I'm lazy, so I like to just unloosen it as much as I can and hope that it doesn't fall out. And then I always want to use my little screwdriver to tighten it right up. There. So now my machine is all set to use the HP needle plate and foot. And when you put that needle plate on, the machine is going to tell you what stitches are available. So it is not going to give you the choice of a zigzag stitch because obviously that's going to probably break your needle. You're certainly going to hit the foot. So it will tell you on the machine what stitches are available. So you'll notice when you put the HP needle plate in that the machine tells you, it recognizes it. So it tells you straight stitching needle plate is set. Please make sure the proper presser foot is attached. So you can just get rid of that by pressing the X on there. And here we are in our utility stitches. So now let's take a look and see what are some of the stitches that you can do with the HP needle plate and with the HP industrial grade foot. So I'm going to look in the generic area at first. So the first one is here, and this is your quarter inch stitch. So this is, as a quilter, we would want to use that. It's also in the quilting area too. But you can start with that and try and see what that looks like. But there are other ones you can do too. And so if you're a sewer, there are some triple stitch options here that would be really nice for top stitching. So let's take a closer look at some of those. Okay, so now I want to do some stitching. And the first thing I want to do is I want to bring up my bobbin thread. Because remember, I just put that needle plate on here, so I haven't really got my thread up. So I'm going to use my up down, my needle up down, to go down and up and just bring up my thread. My bobbin thread is there. And I'm going to show you a few stitches here. Now here is your default stitch that's going to go to first. It's just a straight stitch. So I make sure that I activate my presser foot up or down. You can do that, your automatic presser foot down, I should say. You can do that if you want, or you don't have to, but I like to. And I also use the button on the machine to put my presser foot down first. And I like to put my needle down into the fabric before I start sewing. That's how I always like to start sewing. I don't just let the machine do it all for me. Okay, so right now I'm on stitch one, and this is what it looks like. This is just my utility stitch one. Okay. And just to mention, I have increased my stitch length here to 2.4 on this machine. Usually it'll default to 1.8, which I find really small, but that can be really helpful depending on what you're working with. So there's just a straight stitch going along. All right, let's go to number four because that's where it gets really interesting. So this is like a triple stitch. So let's see what this takes, what this looks like, I should say. Now it's going to give me a lock stitch at the first, and then we're going to go along. So it's going back and forth, back and forth. All right, that's probably enough of that. Let's see what it looks like. So it's looking like this, and you can see that's got much more definition than the straight one. So let's see what else we can do with this little guy. We have some other stitches here too. This one I think is going to give us a few stitches forward and a few stitches back at the beginning to lock it, and we can do that at the end as well. Just get my thread under my foot there. Okay, so it's a straight stitch long, and then when I press my back button, it gives me that locking stitch. All right, so that was stitch number 3, actually. So that's very similar to the first one, but it has the ability, it just automatically will do the locking for you. But let's take a look at what we've got in some of the quilting stitches, because that's really where the fun begins. So when I go into my stitches, my quilting stitches, I've got a choice of 5 different ones. And the first one, I'm just going to move this sample out of the way, because the first one is your quarter inch seam, and that's what I want to use for a lot of my piecing projects, obviously. So let me put my sample underneath here. Put my foot down, put my needle down, and I'm not even at the edge here, so I'll just move over a little bit. There we go. And let's take a look at what that's doing for me. You know, to get an accurate quarter inch seam, you have to have the edge of the foot at the edge of the fabric. Okay, you're not going to get an accurate quarter inch seam away from the edge of your fabric if you haven't got yourself set up right. All right, so there's my quarter inch seam that I would normally do for my piecing. And again, you can change the length of the stitches to whatever works for you, however close you want them or far apart you want them. All right, so that works really well. So that is the quilt stitch number 1, and that's what I would typically use when I'm quilting. Now let's take a look at some of the other ones that we have in here and see what they do. Let's go to number 2 and see what that's going to do for us. This is going to give you more definition again. All right. Okay, we're going to stop that one and see what it looks like. Oh, that's kind of interesting, isn't it? Look at that. You've got like a triple stitch and then we've got a single one in between. So if you look at the icon on the machine, you're going to see that's what it looks like. Oh, that's quite pretty, isn't it? I like that. I think that'd be really nice along a collar or a cuff on a garment, if you're a garment sewer. Okay, let's go to number 3 and see what it looks like. There we go. All right, so on this one, it's the last one we sewed. So this is also like a sort of a triple stitch, but it's longer. You can see the difference in them. And it's got that single one in between, but quite a bit longer. So I'm just going with the machine defaults here. I'm not changing anything myself. So you can see what it does. Of course, you can get all kinds of different looks if you start playing around with the length of the stitches. This happens to be at 5 for that particular one. Let's go to number 4, and this is at 2.5 is the default for the stitch length. Let's see what it's going to do. All right, so here's this one here. So this is like a triple stitch with no single stitch in between. So you get that heavier line again on that particular one. And let's look at number 5. And it's at 5 is for the stitch length, so. Oh yeah, this is going to be a heavier stitch, for sure. Okay, so here's this one. So this is sort of like, I think it was number 3, I guess, or like this one, only heavier. So it's got the heavy stitches and then that single stitch in between. So lots of interesting stitch choices using your HP needle plate and foot. So you can investigate some of those. Certainly if you're a garment sewer, there is lots of opportunity for top stitching with these stitches. They would look beautiful, I think. And I think they might look quite interesting if you're doing walking foot quilting, if you like to do walking foot quilting. Usually you have your walking foot on, but you could try it with your HP foot and see, because you've got some nice choices here that give you a little bit more definition. So that might be really interesting to do if you're thinking of doing some walking foot quilting, only using the HP industrial grade foot and the needle plate. If you liked this video, and I really hope that you did, please give it a thumbs up underneath, a like, just click the like button, and be sure to share it with your friends. And be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel so you will get notifications the next time we post a new video.